right, if you're using Google Sheets, you have a range of data like what we have on the screen right here. You may be contemplating putting it into a table. We're going to go through four examples, starting with this one that doesn't really, it's not helpful to put it in a table, all the way to the fourth one where it's a great idea to put it in a table. It's very helpful. So we'll show you this first spreadsheet and talk about why you shouldn't put it in a table to help you understand when you should. So one of the first problems with this is that column A is really different types of data. So when you come to A2, this is a department where the employees are, but A3 is one of the actual employees. So if you were to sort this, it would lose a lot of its meaning because the structure, the order of the rows, is important with how it's laid out. It's also missing a header here. And there's no numbers or dates in the body of the table, so there's really nothing to sort by. So let's just conclude that the schedule doesn't make sense to go into a table. And let's look at the next example, which is an accounts payable aging schedule. And this could make a little bit more sense to put in a table. So one of the good attributes of this is that every column has a descriptive header. That's a good start. And there are dates and dollar amounts in here, so you could sort and filter by those. But you're going to run into problems with this example also because, one, there are subtotals and report totals. So those don't have any meaning once you change the order of the data. And you have row labels that are not in the same row as the data. So you can see visually why they're here. So the O'Reilly group is talking about all four of these invoices. But if that were to be sorted, it wouldn't make any sense. So you'd have to do a fair amount of work on this before you turned it into a table. And if this is a report that you generate once a month, that's going to be a lot of extra work. So I would recommend leaving a report like this how it is because it's already in its most useful arrangement. Now let's look at a range of data that probably does make sense to put into a table. So let's just put it into a table as we talk about it. We can do that by going to Format, and then we're going to convert it to a table. And what this has done is you'll see that there is one column that's only dates. And since they're dates, one, you can enforce that. So that did that automatically. If you put something in there that is not a date, or give you a warning. And then you can sort by this. So if you want to see your transactions in order, or if you want to see them by the highest price or lowest price, these controls make sense. It also has data in it that you may want to add a formula to. So if you wanted to do the amount times the price, since we're using a table, it will expand the table to capture that. And then when you copy it all the way down, it goes to the bottom of the table. We'll scroll down. And if you were to add a row to the bottom, that formula would copy down. Now, one small reason why you might not want to put this in a table is if this is a static report, right? It's just generated once a month or once a day, and you don't do much with it. You just store it, maybe look back at it occasionally. There's really no value putting it in a table. Leave it the way it was. It's just fine. But if you're going to be working with it, this is probably a good candidate. And now we'll go to the last example. And this kind of is designed to have all the attributes that you would benefit from a table. So let's put it in a table and then we'll talk about it. So we'll say convert to table. And let's say that you're sharing this spreadsheet. So if you were sharing this spreadsheet, you wanted to make sure that the price only gets currency. So you would make sure that this was number and currency was checked. Smart enough to do that automatically. The locations, let's say you want to limit that to just these locations, so you don't want a typo, you don't want someone to type N-O-R-T-H with a lowercase n, and then when you sort it, it will count it as a different location. So what you could do is edit the column type here and change this to dropdowns. And then when someone comes into the spreadsheet and enters West, it will limit them to these choices, so misspelling would not occur. And because these locations only have a few choices, what you can also do is use the column control here and group that by the column, and then all the centrals will be together, east, etc. We'll undo that for now. So tables are great when you're sharing data because you can enforce all of these rules. Let's make sure this one's good too. Obviously that was set to none, but let's tell people it needs to be a number. So if someone comes in here, changes one of these numbers to 55.3.4, they're going to get an error. All right, and if you have lots of sheets in your spreadsheet, you may want to generate an automatic table of contents that has links and AI-generated summaries to label each one. This next video is going to show you an add-on that we've made called Sheet Indexer, and it'll walk you through how to do that for you with just a few clicks. I'll see you in that video. Thanks for watching.